Hello student, very good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think we were discussing about the chapter number 3. The name of that chapter is a rearrangement reaction. Rearrangement reaction means what? How many number of named rearrangement reaction we have learned in detail, and what are the important question may appear in your exam for 1 mark as well as for long question, maybe for 2 or 3 mark. That kind of the discussion we were discuss yesterday. What we are going to learn today is the new topic, and which is the last topic, because there are 9 chapter at semester number 4 TYBSC organic chemistry. So the last chapter, why last chapter I am taking over here, because there are chapter number 5 to 8, there are I think chapter number 4 to 8, they are related to the spectroscopy, and that spectroscopy is very, very important as far as a TYBSC organic chemistry is concerned, and that we will see later on. Before that, whatever theoretical, whatever mechanism type of the chapter that we are trying, that I am trying to complete, and after that we will start as a main spectroscopy, and that spectroscopy is new to you, but that is a very, very interesting because as far as a research point of view is concerned, that is a highly what we can call it as a modern technology, very popularly known as a spectroscopy, and it is designed beautifully so that we can get the perfect structure of the organic compound. And once you know the structure, you can able to predict its physical properties as well as chemical properties of that organic compound. So before that, let us complete the chapter number 9. The name of that chapter is a natural product. What do you mean by the natural product? What are the type of the compound, classification of that compound we are going to learn in this chapter? So that a natural products means it is a they are available in the nature, because there are the various plants are there in the nature, and from that we can extract, we can obtain mainly as a carbohydrates are there, terpenes are there, or amino acid type of the compound we can get, we can extract from the plants. That's why it is totally called as a natural product. So natural product, and there one class we are going to learn, which is a terpenoids. Why it is called as a terpenoid, and how it is how we are going to study in the chapter, how we are going to determine its structure by using as a different method. So that also included in the chapter. So let's begin with that terpenoids. Already written A part is the terpenoids, and that terpenoid means what? The let us see first. One is a introduction about that terpenoids. Terpenoids are naturally occurring compound obtained from various parts of plants. Various parts of plant, there is the root or stem or leaves or whatever sap. So there are the various parts of the plant we can obtain this, or they are occur in the those part, and that's why it is known as a terpenoid. The term terpene was applied to a mixture of isomeric hydrocarbons of the molecular formula let us here C10 and H16 molecular formula. Hydrocarbon, as we know that hydrocarbon, many time I already told you that hydrocarbon means what? The organic compound which is made by carbon and hydrogen atom is known as hydrocarbon. Here the molecular formula is given, C10H16. So that is one of the hydrocarbon, and that type of the compound are known as a terpenoid, and occurring its terpentine and many other essential oils, and you know that essential oils, and this is one of the term generally we are going to study in this. So these are the terpenoid, but as the discovery of a large number of related compounds increase with time, the definition of the term was also modified to cover all the compounds of the empirical formula, that is C5H8. This is the empirical formula, means the smallest unit which is known as a empirical formula, and that empirical formula is repeatedly occurring in the in those compound, and that's why that type is called as a terpenoid. If you double it, C10 H16, and it is belonging to as a terpenoid, it is one of the compound, but C5H8, it is a empirical formula, means the smallest molecular formula, and it is repeatedly occurring in those natural products under the terpenoids, this one, and the C5H8 unit is called as isoprene unit. Look at this one, this is the empirical formula, and this is the smallest unit, and this smallest unit is called as isoprene unit. This is known as isoprene unit. This is known as isoprene unit, or which is the empirical formula of all the natural product, even though here is a terpenoid, we are discussing over here isoprene unit, this one, and now, and this isoprene unit, the name of that isoprene unit, IUPAC name of this compound is a 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. The structure we can draw very simple, this one, this is the structure of this. There are 5 carbon atom and 8 hydrogen atom. If you write this in a simplified way, like this, this CH2 double bond, then CH, then CH, CS3, not CH, here double bond, then CH2. Look at, if you count the number of carbon atom over there, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one is a 5, so C5 is there, and now count the number of hydrogen atom, let's see here, 2, 3, 6, 7, and 8. So this is the molecular formula of that isoprene unit, which is the smallest or the empirical formula, and the structure, this is according to as a zigzag structure, and or according to as a and so this is the isoprene unit. The IUPAC name of this compound at 2 position is a methyl group, so you can call it as a 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene indicate as a 2-carbon-carbon double bond present in that organic compound. At what position they are present? They are present at 1 and 3 position, and therefore it is written as 1,3, but indicate as a 4-carbon atom in the straight chain, and diene indicate as a 2-carbon-carbon double bond present in that compound, and that's why this is a isoprene unit, and their IUPAC name of that area. The basic repeating unit in all terpenes, look at this one, and if you multiply it, you will get the definite repeating unit you will find in the terpenes. And since all of these compounds are composed of isoprene unit, and they are also known as isoprenoids. We can call it as a terpenoid from terpene and isoprenoid due to the presence of repeating unit of isoprene. So we can call it as a isoprenoid also for this thing. And now is the terpenes are therefore defined as a natural product which consists of one or more isoprene unit, that is this one C5H8, where n is equal to 1, 3, 4... These are the repeating unit are occurring in that terpenoids. And that now is the occurrence, where it is occur in the nature, that is the occurrence. They are in essential oils, and they are in essential oils. Essential oils, they are occurring, and there are two types of terpenoids. So how many types of terpenoids? There are two types of terpenoids. Let us see over here. Terpenoids is get divided or get classified into two types. Number one is this one, simple terpenoids, and second one is called as a complex terpenoids. These are the two types of the terpenoids. One is a simple terpenoid, another one is a complex terpenoids. And now, what do you mean by the simple terpenoids? Simple terpenoid means what, and where, and from where it is occur, and that we are going to see over here. And they occur in essential oils which are steam holotype. These kind of the simple terpenoids, they occur in essential oils. They are occur in the essential oils, and mainly they are the steam holotype means what? This is a one of the technique. Along with that steam, these terpenoid we can separate from the from that other part of that extract. So that is called as a steam holotype. They come along with that steam and come along with the steam, essential oils which are steam holotype and obtained from sap and tissues of certain plants and trees. And they are obtained from sap. Sap means that what we can call it as a syrup, and from tissues of various parts of plants. So these are the what we can call it as a terpenoid. They are classified into as a two type. One is a simple terpenoid, another one is a complex terpenoid. And simple terpenoid, where they are occur, they are mainly occur in the essential oils, and they are the steam holotype, and they can be extracted, they can be obtained from sap and tissues of the various plants and the trees. So that is all about the complex, all about the simplest terpenoid. Now, where the complex terpenoid will occur, from where we can get these complex terpenoids. So let us see here, complex terpenoid, they are not steam volatile. They are not the steam volatile and obtained from the gum and resin of plants. And they are not steam volatile. They are not steam volatile. Steam volatile. They are not the steam volatile. They are not coming with that steam because they are the high boiling point. And now complex terpenoid, they are not steam volatile, but they are obtained from gum and resins of the plants, resins of the plants. So these are the, what we can call it as occurrences of this terpenoid, from where they are occur. So that is the whole story we have seen over here. So these terpenoids, the classification of the terpenoid here, just remember how these terpenoid is get classified. There are the two broad classes of that terpenoid. One is the simplest terpenoid, another one is a complex terpenoid. And that simple terpenoid which is occur in essential oils, they are the steam volatile and they are generally obtained from sap and tissues of the different plants and the trees. Now second one is a complex terpenoid. Complex terpenoid generally are the not steam volatile. They are not the steam volatile and they are generally obtained from gum and the resins. This is all about the complex terpenoid and the what we can call it as a simple terpenoid. And some cheap constituent of simple terpenoid obtained from essential oils are, number one is a lemongrass oil, which is the citral, and eucalyptus oil, that is cinnamon oil, turpentine oil, that is pinene, and rose and lavender oil, that is geranium oil, and the neroli, and what we can call it as a peppermint oil, that is obtained from that is a menthol. So these are the what we can call it a cheap constituents of this particular cheap constituent of the simplest terpenoid. Now isolation and the purification, how we can isolate it, how we can obtain it, how we can get in a pure form, and that's why it is called as a isolation and the purification. Isolation and the purification. Isolation means what? How we can obtain this type of the terpenoid, how we can purify it, because when we are getting it is not in the pure form, they are always in the combined form, and therefore it needed the purification. So we are going to learn here some of the technique of isolation and the purifications are there. In general, four method have been developed for the isolation of essential oils. Four method have been developed for the isolation of essential oils from plant material. That is, first one is a expression method. First one is the expression method. Second will be the steam distillation method. Second one, steam distillation method. And third one is a solvent extraction. Extraction. And the fourth one is a adsorption. Adsorption in purified fat. So these are the four method for the isolation of these terpenoids. Expression, isolation, there are four method of the isolation. Number one is the expression method, second one is the steam distillation, third one is the solvent extraction, and fourth one is the adsorption in purified fats. These are the four main method for the isolation of these terpenoids. Number one, let us see one by one. First one is the expression method. Expression method, how it is used for isolation of this terpenoid. Let us see here some description regarding that expression method. The plant material is crushed. The plant material is crushed and juice is screened and screened to remove the large particles. So this is the step number first. The plant is crushed thoroughly and that juice is screened so that the large particle of that is removed, and the juice is centrifugated. There is a centrifuge type of the machine, so circulations are there, and this is one of the technique where the whatever some solid particles are there, they settle down at the bottom and the solution, super solution, is upper side. So this is one of the centrifugation is a technique where we can separate solid from liquid. So that is known as centrifugated. When nearly half of the essential oil is obtained in the centrifugate, the residue means solid particle, the residue is used for the isolation of inferior of oil by distillation, citrus, lemon and gross oil are obtained by this method. So this is the first method we have seen, citrus or what we can lemon and the gross oil are obtained by this method. This is one of the what we can call it as isolation method by obtaining as a different terpenoids. Now let us look at the second one. Second isolation method is the steam distillation. And steam distillation, the plant material is kept under steam distillation so that the steam volatile terpenoid come along steam and from which they are extracted by the use of pure organic solvent, solvent like light petroleums. But this is not the ideal method because due to heat treatment, structure of many constituent of an essential oil may undergo change. For example, aldehyde are there. Due to the heating, that aldehyde may convert into carboxylic acid, means that what we can call it as oxidation may occur over there, and therefore this method is somewhat what we can call it as less than the above method. The acid gets decarboxylated, acid get decarboxylation because acid has a tendency to get decarboxylation, means carbon dioxide get evolved during this process, and you may get as a this type of the problem you may face over here. Another one, ester get hydrolyzed. After hydrolysis of ester, what is going to happen? As we know that RC double bond O R dash, it is a structure of ester, and when it is hydrolyzed with that water, hydrolysis, what is going to get? R C double bond OH and plus R OH. One is acid and one is you will get as a alcohol. So this type of the conversion may occur during this process, and this also affect the order of the essential ion. This also affect the order of essential oils, and even then this method is used due to its low cost. But this method has a very low cost, and therefore they are using for beneficiary of that this type of the this type of the terpenoids, because we can obtain the essential oils in a low cost. And now the third one is a solvent extraction. Solvent extraction in inorganic chemistry, you might have heard this word solvent extraction, how it is useful for obtaining such type of the pure compound. The crushed plant material is extracted with a solvent like petroleum ether 40 to 60 degree or diethyl ether. Boiling point has a diethyl ether has a boiling point is a 37 degree centigrade. As we know, the body's temperature of human being is a 37 degree centigrade, and the extract is then subjected to distillation, and the solvent is recovered, and the treatment is not allowed to exceed 50 degree centigrade, because that heating is exceed more than 50 degree centigrade, there will be a possibility of decomposition, and that's why it is avoided. And the essential oil obtained by this method has the natural order. It does not lose the natural order, whatever is there, it remains there. And this is the best but most expensive. This is the best but the most expensive method among all these, because there are four methods. Among all these four methods, this steam distillation, it is one of the expensive method, because there we are getting the order of that is written, natural order is maintained while getting this terpenoids. Okay, then last one, which one is absorption in purified fat, that is influence. And in this method first the fat is taken in a glass plate and warm to above 50 degree centigrade, and then flower petals are spread on the surface of the flat, and it is kept for several days until the fat is saturated with essential oils, for which the old petal may be replaced by the fresh one. And the fat is now digested with ethanol, so that essential oil dissolve in ethanol. If some fat is also dissolved during the digestion, and it is remove the solvent, the essential, it is removed by cooling about 20 degree centigrade, and the extract is distilled under reduced pressure. Do you know this word reduced pressure? Means whatever boiling point of that solvent, the reduced pressure is applied over there, and they can come before that boiling point, then that is the what we can call it as a term, reduced pressure is used over here. The essential oil obtained usually contain a number of terpenoids, and these are separated by fractional distillation. And now is a purification. Whatever we have seen, all are the isolation method. There are the four isolation method, different four method we can get as a different type of the terpenoid. Now is a purification, and the terpene isolated from the different plant sources are always obtained as a mixture of one or more terpenes and other plant products, and the component of mixture are further separated and purified using techniques such as fractional distillation, fractional crystallization, chromatographic techniques such as thin layer chromatography, column chromatography, gas liquid chromatography, GLC, and high performance liquid chromatography, that is HPLC. These are the some of the technique are used while purification of this terpenoids. I think with this we have seen all this general, what we can call it as a general introduction regarding as a terpenoids. So tomorrow onward we are going to learn about the classification of the terpenoid, how that terpenoid get classified. So depending upon that classification, we will see the rest of the point regarding that. So this is a general introduction. We have talk about that natural products. So with this, let us stop today here. Remaining we will see next time. Have a nice day. Thank you.